In many cultures around the world, there are quite a few legends, myths, and stories about women who took up arms and fought like warriors. In the Norse myths, they were called Shield-Maidens, or Skjaldmeyjar. I have no idea if I'm pronouncing that correctly. But were these women real? Unlike the Amazons, their Greek counterpart, Shield-Maidens were not an entire culture of women, but instead singular women who trained as fighters. The reason why they may have picked up weapons are numerous, from self-defense to just plain old, I like to beat people's skulls in. But whatever their motivations, there are quite a few famous fighters amongst them, like Brynhildr, Hervor, Thorbjörg, and Vaborg. Sound like an awesome Norseman. All of these women fought like men, taking on the world with a sword or a bow for either love, revenge, or just plain survival. It has to be noted though, there is a very interesting trend with these characters. All of these women and others like them end up returning to their traditional roles as mother or wife. As a result, a lot of historians and mythologists feel these are more charter myths for social constructs than anything else, to show that women had a role in society, and no matter how far they deviated from that, they always returned to what they were meant to do. It should be also noted, though, that these women were praised for their ability to break away from the norm. They were admired and feared and never scorned, despite eventually returning to a traditional role. This suggests they were far more admired for their ability than damned for their audacity to fight like men. Women who have been buried with weapons are not as uncommon as one would think, but still there is doubt if these were warriors or if they were simply buried with weapons for some other obscure reason. These weapons could have been from the husband or son. We can make an assumption, but with no context as to why the weapons were buried there, we can't make an accurate conclusion. Hard evidence just doesn't exist to support the idea of shield maidens. And even though the word shield maiden does exist in the context of Norse language, it is often interchanged with Valkyrie, the goddess-like woman who took fighters up to Valhalla, pulling them further and further into the myth territory and out of the legendary. But here is the interesting bit. Before we could identify gender by scientific means, skeletons and graves were often gender-identified by what they were buried with. If they had weapons, they were considered men, because men in those days usually took up the mantle of protector and fighter. Each gender had roles, and because there were no easy means to identify remains back then, many historians and archaeologists had to base assumptions on how societies were structured and which roles were traditionally filled by which gender. Hence, weapon and grave equaled male grave. However, recent studies do show that some of these graves with weapons were actually women. So the amount of graves that were inaccurately identified simply based on assumption could be numerous, but this is as well just an assumption. But heading back into history, we can see numerous women who could be considered warriors and who did exist and were recorded as fact. One would be the Omna Bugaish, who were the wives of the samurai, trained as fighters and charged with protecting villages during war. And then of course we have the most famous of all, the Amazons. Although firmly planted in myth, it is still debated to this day on whether they were real or not. I will say though, if I had to compare the Amazons with the Shield Maidens, I would believe in the possibility of the Shield Maiden far more than I would in the Amazon. It's a smaller idea to get a handle on. They weren't a whole culture that needs to have a city, a territory, a pocket of existence. They were simply people of an established and confirmed civilization who wanted to fight. Hard evidence or no, logic dictates it is a strong possibility, especially seeing as they are mentioned quite prolifically in the myths and legends. And as we know, a lot of old stories often hold a grain of truth. So yes, shield maidens do have a larger possibility of existing than they do not. Don't forget to subscribe. More information on shield maidens can be found in the links below, and thanks for watching.